Good morning. Today is the 33rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Under the leadership of the Capuchin Franciscan Friars and in union with the Roman Catholic Archdiocese of Philadelphia, St. John's welcomes all who are present with us today in praising God and serving God's people. At 10:30 Mass only, the people of St. John and Holy Redeemer welcome Bishop Timothy Sr. for the installation of our new pastor, Father Tom Betz. Young Adult Outreach, this Wednesday, November 16th, 6:30 p.m., we will have adoration, libation, and an hour of adoration and prayer in the lower church, followed by socialization in a local pub. All young adult people in their 20s and 30s are invited and welcome. St. Charles Seminary Collection. The annual appeal for St. Charles Seminary is one of the most important collections for the Philadelphia Archdiocese. The appeal assists seminarians studying for the priesthood and those preparing to be permanent deacons, as well as lay people preparing for church ministry. The collection will be next weekend, November 19th to the 20th. Christmas gifts for pre-medica patients. For many years, on Christmas Eve, Holy Redeemer children have gone to the nursing home slash rehab facility at 16th and Lombard Streets. The children will sing Christmas carols and give each resident a wrapped Christmas gift. Please consider buying a few gifts, wrapping them, and mark them M, F, or E, male, female, or either. St. John Church serves people who live, work, and visit Center City, Philadelphia. St. John's receives no subsidy from the Archdiocese and is entirely dependent on donations from our parishioners and visitors. We asked our visitors to be generous with our collection so that St. John's can be a vibrant Catholic presence in Center City. In this Mass, we will remember in prayer the people of St. John the Evangelist Parish for whom this Mass is offered. A celebrant for this Mass is Bishop Timothy Sr., Father Tom Betz. As we are about to begin, please turn off or silence all cell phone, paging devices, or any device that may cause a disruption or a distraction. Thank you.
Our opening hymn is number 420, All Are Welcome, 420.
Yeah. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace be with you. My sisters and brothers, it's a great grace to celebrate the Eucharist with you here this morning to visit St. John the Evangelist and Holy Redeemer Parish. And it's particularly grace to have the occasion be the installation of your new pastor, Father Tom Betz, to welcome him back to Philadelphia. Today, the words of the gospel are somewhat sobering in that they remind us, as we come towards the end of this liturgical year, of the end times. But Jesus consoles us and encourages us to persevere in faith and not to be afraid, no matter what happens, because we live and walk in his light, the light of the Son of Justice, which shines upon us with healing rays. And so to prepare ourselves for this encounter, we call to mind our need for those healing rays, as the prophet Malachi describes it in our first reading, the healing rays of God's mercy and forgiveness. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve you with constancy, the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Malachi. Lo, the day is coming, blazing like an oven, when all the proud and all the evildoers will be stubble. And the day that is coming will set them on fire, leaving them neither root nor branch, says the Lord of hosts. But for you, who fear my name, there will arise the Son of Justice with its healing rays. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know how one must imitate us, for we did not act in a disorderly way among you, nor did we eat food received free from anyone. On the contrary, in toil and drudgery, night and day, we worked so that not to burden any of you, not that we do not have the right. Rather, we wanted to present ourselves as a model for you so that you might imitate us. In fact, when we were with you, we instructed you that if anyone was unwilling to work, neither should that one eat. We hear that some are conducting themselves among you in a disorderly way by not keeping busy but minding the business of others. Such people we instruct and urge in the Lord Jesus Christ to work quietly and to eat their own food. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
While some people were speaking about how the temple was adorned with costly stones and votive offerings, Jesus said, "All that you see here, the days will come when there will not be left a stone upon another stone that will not be thrown down." Then they asked him, "Teacher, when will this happen? And what sign will there be when all these things are about to happen?" He answered, "See that you may not be deceived, for many will come in my name, saying, 'I am he,' and 'the time has come.' Do not follow them. When you hear of wars and insurrections, do not be terrified, for such things must happen first, but it will not immediately be the end." Then he said to them, "Nation will rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom. There will be powerful earthquakes, famines, and plagues from place to place, and awesome sights, and mighty signs will come from the sky. Before all this happens, however, they will seize and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and to prisons, and they will have you led before kings and governors because of my name. It will lead to your giving testimony. Remember, you are not to prepare your defense beforehand, for I myself will give you a wisdom in speaking that all your adversaries will be powerless to resist or refute. You will even be handed over by parents, brothers, relatives, and friends, and they will put some of you to death. You will be hated by all because of my name, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Once again, it's a grace to be with you here this morning for this celebration of the Eucharist. I want to greet you on behalf of our Archbishop, Nelson Perez, and in a warm way, once again, to welcome Father Thomas Betz, who has been here since September, returning to the Archdiocese. Father Betz and Archbishop Perez and I were all working together in the 1990s and beyond, and who could have imagined that we would be in this position we are today by God's providence. And it is also a continuation of the great gift to the Church of Philadelphia that the Capuchin Friars have been for now almost 30 years, I believe, here at St. John's and Holy Redeemer in particular. So we're just blessed by our Capuchin brothers and for their ministry, which is so active and so important in the Church of Philadelphia. The installation of a new pastor of any parish is an opportunity to think about our parish, and think about why it's important to us, and why it is an important part of our lives. What do we hold as most special or significant in the parish? Whether, I'm sure some of you have been part of this community for a very long time, and others maybe not so long, maybe others are visiting for the first time. But think about that important place that parish holds in our lives as Catholics. Ultimately, it's a community of faith. A community of faith that helps us, it's the context where we grow in faith through the sacraments, most especially through our coming to understand God's words and the teachings of the faith that have been handed down to us. It's also the place where we celebrate the great moments of our lives, the happy moments, the joyful times of weddings and baptisms and confirmations and first communions and transitions in our lives, and where we are consoled when we lose a loved one, when we're going through difficult times, when we have fallen away from our faith and we need God's mercy and forgiveness. The healing that we receive within that community perhaps is the most poignant and most important part of any parish community. But growing in the life of faith is a lifelong work, of course. We're disciples of Jesus Christ who are continually looking at what that means for us and what we need to do to grow in discipleship. And that does happen within the parish in a really important way. And the word of God proclaimed each week shapes us, forms us as disciples, reminds us of what it's really all about. And this Sunday, these words for the 33rd Sunday in ordinary time, as we come to the end of the liturgical year, do speak of that, what it's all about, in a kind of a sobering way, a challenging way, that we are ultimately growing in discipleship and in faith within this parish and in any parish, because we are destined for union with God forever. And for that encounter with our loving God, who has breathed life into us and has unconditional love for each one of us, that is some moment for which we are always preparing. We're called to be ready to encounter him. And that comes with challenges. It comes with difficulties. It comes with challenges, particularly when things seem to be going awry in our lives, in the world, in our community, in the church. And that is what Jesus seems to be talking about in the gospel to me. He's sitting with a group of people in Jerusalem, and they're admiring the temple of Jerusalem, how the temple was adorned with costly stones and votive offerings. And Jesus says something which must have shocked them, certainly upset them. He says, all that you see here, the days will come where there will not be left a stone upon another stone that will not be thrown down. They must have been horrified. What's he talking about? How could this be? That's unthinkable. This is the temple of Jerusalem, where the God of Israel dwells among his people. How could the temple be destroyed? It's a horrifying thought for them, very unsettling, the unimaginable. And then Jesus continues with other unimaginable things. Very difficult times await us, he says. But don't think that just because there are wars and insurrections that the end is coming. Nation will rise against nation, kingdom against kingdom, powerful earthquakes, famines, plagues, awesome sights and mighty signs in the sky. And then people will seize you and persecute you. They will hand you over to the synagogues and prisons, and you'll be led before kings and governors because of my name. People will hate you because of me. But then he says, but not a hair on your head will be destroyed. By your perseverance, you will secure your lives. Well, sometimes our lives can get that confusing, can't they? And we may look at our world today and we may say, the unthinkable is happening. Dramatic change that we experience. First of all, just the presence of violence, the violent expression of hatred in our world that we see playing out every day in places like Ukraine and other parts of the world, Sudan, other places where there is great hatred and violence, hostility. We see it playing out in the rampant violence in our own city, which frightens us. Seems the senseless taking of innocent human life so often. People in the midst of struggles with addictions, poverty. What we've lived through with COVID-19, that's a plague. And the lack of respect for human life along the continuum of life and the injustice, the inequity, the economic injustice that we continue to see in our own country, and especially even more so in other parts of the world, the violence against the environment, against God's creation. Surely we must be saying, it must be getting close. If it's not coming immediately, well, and we're certainly seeing lots of signs. But Jesus doesn't want us to focus on that.
He wants us to remember that not a hair on our head will be destroyed, and that perseverance in our faith, in our growth in discipleship, enables us to secure our lives. That in fact, as St. Paul says, it really is the need not just to think about what is happening around us, as important as that is and how much we need to pray, but we need to focus on growing as disciples. You know, Paul speaks to the Thessalonians about what surely were problems in their community. People were not getting along. It has something to do with the distribution of food and who has what. It has to do with people who are not really serving the community, not keeping busy, but minding the business of others. All of this must have been so tense. Well, that's the nitty-gritty, day-in and day-out place where we grow as disciples. It happens in families, happens in our workplace, happens in parishes, in our communities. We encounter the Holy Spirit working in our lives as we seek to be ever more faithful. And that's perseverance, as Jesus calls us to. We also hear this wonderful vision of the prophet Malachi, how he warns the day is coming blazing like an oven when all the proud and all evildoers will be stubble, and the day that is coming will set them on fire, leaving neither root nor branch. But for you who fear my name, there will arise the Sun of Justice with its healing rays. As Christians, we always walk in the light. The Sun of Justice is to be our guide. And we're to be inflamed with that Sun of Justice, with that vision of God's kingdom, to be instruments of justice, to be instruments of healing. First receiving that justice and healing ourselves in the wounds that we carry, but also being instruments and channels of mercy, living our discipleship, perseverance in faith. My brothers and sisters, we may be distracted and worried and frightened and anxious about the events happening around us in the world, in our city, often in our families and our relationships. But Jesus invites us to trust in his love and to turn towards the ever-present rising Sun of Justice and allow those healing rays to penetrate our hearts, every corner of our hearts, so that we will be found whenever the day comes for his return, persevering in faith, growing in love and mercy, and living that Sun of Justice, reflecting his mercy and following Jesus Christ.
Father John, you may be remain seated, please. No problem. I ask Father John to read the decree of Archbishop Nelson Perez appointing Father Betz as your new pastor.
Most Reverend Nelson J. Perez, by the grace of God and the favor of the Apostolic See, Archbishop of Philadelphia, decree: for the welfare of the people of God, I hereby appoint you, Reverend Thomas R. Betz, OFM Cap, as pastor of St. John the Evangelist and Holy Redeemer Parish, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, effective on September 1, 2022. As soon as possible from this date onward, you shall take canonical possession of the parish when the regional bishop shall preside at the ceremony of your installation. From the moment of your installation as pastor, you shall obtain the full pastoral care of souls in this parish and are bound to exercise it for the good of the people entrusted to you with all the jurisdiction, faculties, duties, rights, and privileges attached thereto. In accord with the sacred canons of the church, as well as the proper law of the Archdiocese of Philadelphia, may God grant you the grace and health to carry out your duties in this new ministry of priestly service for its souls. Nelson J. Perez, Archbishop of Philadelphia, given at Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, on July 28, 2022.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven,
and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary.
For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come.
My dear friends, I now commend Father Betz to you as your pastor. And at this time, I ask the other clergy and representatives of this parish community to come forward on behalf of all to greet Father Tom.
We'd ask the members of the Holy Redeemer and St. John's Parish Council who are present to please come to the front of the church. Everyone else can be seated.
Thank you.
please stand now for our universal prayer? Jesus warns us that there will be difficulties and troubles. Jesus also promises us that we will not face life's problems alone. Confident that we are cared for by God in every circumstance, let us now offer our prayers.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, Bishop Perez, for Bishop Timothy Sr., and for Father Tom Betz, our new pastor, we ask God to strengthen all the church's pastors and to give them wisdom and courage as they care for God's people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the Lord will inspire and strengthen those who are elected this week to service in public office. We ask God to help them put aside personal ambition and to always serve the common good. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace on earth and for all who live in war-torn lands, we pray especially for the people of Ukraine. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will inspire the world's leaders to take actions to protect the environment, to assure clean water and air, and to protect the world from climate change. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, that they will be forgiven for their sins and find a home in heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the people of St. John the Evangelist Parish, for whom this Mass is offered, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all benefactors of St. John's Church, for the intentions in our book of prayer, and those that each of us offers now in silence, we pray to the Lord.
Father in heaven, we need your help as we journey through life and towards heaven. Hear our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Our offertory hymn is number 623, The Cry of the Poor, 623. The Lord.
Pray, dear friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise, for through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ.
May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. John the Evangelist, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help.
May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, and with your servant Pope Francis and our Bishop Nelson and the order of bishops of the clergy, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world.
To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Father's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Share with one another a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof,
but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 394. Here I am, Lord, 394.
Is it all?
Our meditation hymn is Prayer of St. Francis, number 528.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of this sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity through Christ our Lord.
I think it's interesting that on the Sunday when I'm installed as pastor of Holy Redeemer and St. John churches, that the gospel today says when the people saw the beautiful temple, that Jesus said, all that you see here, the days will come when there will not be one stone left upon another that will not be thrown down. I certainly hope that's not a prediction of my time here as pastor. I don't think it is. I think the part that I want to focus on is Jesus saying that he'll be with us no matter what the future will bring. First of all, I want to thank Bishop Timothy Sr. for being here. When he pulled up in his car and he got out of his car, he said to me, Tom, welcome home. And that's and that's exactly the way I feel. I remember it was in July 30th, 1991. I was a newly ordained priest, and we drove into this little street. Really not a street, is it? It's an alley, next to the church here, Ludlow. And I was, first time I ever saw St. John's, first time I ever saw Center City, Philadelphia, and it was overwhelming. I mean, all these skyscrapers and all the busyness of Center City and the busyness of St. John's. And then a few days later, I was at Holy Redeemer, and I was just mesmerized by all the mystery that seemed to be Chinatown. And I remember with Holy Redeemer, it was that first Chinese New Year that I fell madly in love with Holy Redeemer and the Chinese community and Chinatown, and it was wonderful. So my first time to come here in 1991 was just overwhelming. St. John's, Center City, Chinatown, Holy Redeemer. I was here 25 years, Holy Redeemer, and living here at St. John's. I never wanted anything else but to be here. And then those friars. They voted me to be the superior, to be the minister provincial of the community. So I had to leave for 6 years. And everyone knows I came back to Philly as often as I could. And I always said I was going to come back, but it was no guarantee. But fortunately, I was sent back here to be pastor. And I'm so happy to be here. And now this is all I ever want. This is all I want. Now I'm happy to be here, to be pastor of St. John's and Holy Redeemer. For as long as I have health, I'm happy to do this. I'm happy to be a Philadelphia priest again. Even though I'm a member of religious order, Bishop Sr. knows, I am a priest of the Archdiocese of Philadelphia as well, in a big way. So I'm back. And I've been warmly welcomed back here and at Holy Redeemer. And I feel wonderful. I want to give great thanks to Father John Dea, who was here 12 years. He's not here today, but he served Holy Redeemer St. John's with all his heart. He did a great job, and I have big shoes to fill. My first couple days here, I kept thinking, yeah, just give him a... I called him after I was here a couple days and said, man, you worked hard, because there's a lot to do. And he did it all with great humility and great love. And he was back last weekend for Abe's wedding and for Mass at Holy Redeemer. And he promised me he'll come back as often as he can. You know, so I hope we'll see him often. He's our friend. The past few years for St. John's and Holy Redeemer haven't been easy. COVID. Mass attendance is down at both places. And here at St. John's, mostly the weekday Mass attendance is down because the office workers haven't come back, not all, and they're not coming back, not all. We have empty storefronts around here. We have a huge problem with drug addiction and homelessness, people really struggling to survive on the streets, addicted to drugs. So this is our reality. But brothers and sisters, we are called to be Christians here. It's no value to lament. What changed? That's not where Jesus didn't call us to be at St. John's 10 years ago. He called us to be here now. And so we have to respond to the reality that we face in our neighborhood, in our community, in our city. We have to work hard at Holy Redeemer to bring the enrollment of the school up again. We have to work hard at Holy Redeemer to get people back to Mass. And at St. John's, the same thing. We have to get people, well, we don't have a school, but we need to get people back to Mass. We need to invite them to join us for Mass. There are hopeful signs, though. The Mass attendance is going up. Both Holy Redeemer and St. John's have enough money to fund our operations. And at St. John's, there's also about 20 to 25% of the people who attend Mass on Sunday at St. John's are in their 20s and 30s. We have a young community here at St. John's, and that's wonderful. So, all of you, with me, let's work together. Let's be the light of Christ in Center City, Philadelphia, in Chinatown. Let's be the light of Christ. Let's bring people back to the church. Let's invite people to come to know Christ. Let's make this church, St. John's Holy Redeemer, let's make them thrive. We can do that together. I want to thank Annette and the choir for your lovely job today. They often get applause on Sundays. I never get applause. They often get applause. But I'm really proud of our music ministry here, our servers, our reader, those help today. We have a reception after Mass in the Parish Center, so you're all welcome to come back, go along the Ludlow Street, past the cemetery, and join your brothers and sisters for a little refreshment and some fellowship. I'm happy to be your pastor, and I'm glad to be back. Praise God.
Let's ask God to bless all of us, in a special way to bless this parish community of St. John's and Holy Redeemer and Father Betz. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
May the blessing of Almighty God, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Go forth, glorifying the Lord by your life.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn is number 732. Alleluia, sing to Jesus, 732.